Hello everybody and welcome to video number 16 of the free online version of the Fusion Research Lecture. We are in chapter 3, parameter limits for fusion plasmas, and you might remember in the last video we talked about the external kink instability, and in this video we will talk about the internal kink instability. So internal kink instability will be the topic of today's video. For the internal kink instability, we set the separatrix to be fixed, meaning we set the perturbation at the separatrix, so psi at A, to be zero, which is the same as saying, as I just said, that we have a fixed separatrix. Then analyzing the energy principle or applying the energy principle, we then find that such perturbations, so perturbations of the inside of the plasma, are generally stable for mode numbers m being larger than 1. For m equals 1, this implies, as you might have guessed already, that there is an unstable mode. And this is unstable if the safety factor in the plasma center, so QS at 0, is smaller than 1 over n. And for n equals 1, this means that we get an unstable mode, because we then have the condition that QS, or we can get an unstable mode, sorry, that QS at the center has to be smaller than 1 for instability. So this is a condition for instability. And since usually we have a safety factor in the center of the tokamaks being smaller than 1, being on the order of 0.7, we have such a mode there. So usually the safety factor in the tokamak, the typical tokamak, is on the order of 0.7 in the center. And that means we have such a one mode which is unstable, or that generally 1-1 modes are generally unstable in typical tokamaks in the plasma center. And those modes, or these modes, have a special name, and they are called, or these modes, let's say, have a sawtooth shape. Thus they are also referred to as sawteeth. So they have a sawtooth shape in the time traces of temperature and plasma density. As you can see in these time traces. So you see two time traces in the top from the Asdex upgrade tokamak, and a time trace in the center. This is the one where we look at now, and the time trace at the plasma boundary. And this is a soft X-ray radiation being proportional to density and temperature. You can see how the soft X-ray radiation increases in the plasma center, then it suddenly drops. This is what we call a crash. Then it increases again, it suddenly drops, then it increases again, it suddenly drops, and so on. And this is a sawtooth-like behavior. So here we have a so-called sawtooth instability. What this is basically is, as we just talked about, a slow increase. The slow increase is related to the finite, or to the diffusion time of the plasma current. Because it takes a while for the plasma current profile to evolve spatially. This is what we meant. We have a finite diffusion time. This is why we only have a slow increase in the soft X-ray radiation. And then a sudden decrease, a sudden crash afterwards. And obviously this has some kind of a periodic behavior. So this is a periodic behavior, and it limits, or it imposes a limit on the temperature, density, and also on the plasma current peaking. And it is sometimes, in principle, it's also a relaxation instability because it relaxes a bit the plasma pressure. Now, this instability can be good. So it can be good. Oops. It can be good because it can transport in a burning plasma where you have fusion reactions going on, it can transport the helium ash outwards. So it can help to transport the helium ash outwards. And it is, however, only good as long as it is controlled. As long as it is controlled, because these sawtooth instabilities can also trigger, in principle, NTMs, something which we already talked about in video number 9. To correctly describe the sawtooth, so a correct description requires actually to take into account resistivity. So we require finite resistivity. So we have to say goodbye to ideal MHD here, because what we observe just before the sawtooth crash, so before the sudden drop of the soft X-ray radiation in the center, a rotating 1-1 island in the center. So this is just before the crash. And as you know, islands require finite resistivity. All the physics details about this sawtooth behavior is however not fully understood and still subject of active research, both in the experiment as well as in simulations. Now, since we talked about finite resistivity, we can start to talk about tearing modes. Tearing modes. So if we have finite resistivity, if we allow for finite resistivity and then apply the energy principle analysis, it yields that for mode numbers M being larger than 1, there are unstable kink modes which can appear, and those kink modes are referred to as tearing modes. So tearing modes are basically kink modes where you allow for finite resistivity, so where you no longer have the case of ideal MHD. And since we have finite resistivity, of course, as I just said already in the last slide, it means the formation of magnetic islands are possible now. Formation of magnetic islands. Just as a brief reminder, we already talked about islands, but it's good to just repeat it here. If we have here a radial coordinate and into this direction theta, the poloidal angle, then we might have something like this. So, well, can try to draw it a bit nicer, a bit more symmetric. Something like this. An island structure here, flux surface configuration encapsulated in the background configuration, where we have here the X point. Here is another X point of the island. In the center, we have the O point. And why are islands a problem? You might remember islands are a problem because they allow for radial transport with the velocity of the parallel transport. Now, why that? Because here, basically on this flux surface, all these areas are connected and they are in a configuration without an island, they would be radially separated, which means slow transport. However, they are now no longer radially separated. They are connected via the magnetic field lines. Thus, we have now the fast parallel transport into that direction. So, transport, just as a reminder, transport along the field lines is fast. And thus, we basically have the same plasma pressure around an island. This means we have the same plasma pressure around the magnetic island. And this means we get a flattening of the plasma pressure profile. So this means we get a flattening of the plasma pressure profile across the O point of the island. Let's make a drawing of that situation. So now here we have the plasma pressure. The plasma pressure P, small p. Here we have a radial coordinate. Then the plasma pressure profile without islands might look, for example, like this. So this is the case with no magnetic island. With magnetic island, it might look like this. So we have the same increase coming from the outboard side. And then, however, we pass the O point of an island where we have the same plasma pressure and then it increases. So this is the example with an island. So here we have a magnetic island and this is a profile across the O point. And as you can easily imagine, this is bad for confinement because the plasma pressure profile drops there. And well, this one here would refer to the width of the island, W. And as a conclusion, islands are in general bad for confinement. Now, this is not the end of the story. It can become even more problematic. To understand that, please allow me to make a brief preview on a topic which we will discuss in a later lecture. That is the bootstrap current. So we have the bootstrap current. This is a current which is generated by the plasma itself. So it's a self-generated current which is driven by the plasma pressure gradient in combination with collisions between particles which are trapped in the magnetic field configuration. This is like trapping similar to particles from the sun, which are emitted from the sun, and then trapped in the magnetic field of the Earth, which can then lead to the northern lights or the southern lights. So collision between trapped particles and particles which are not trapped in the magnetic field configuration. Those are called passing particles. Again, this is something we will discuss in more detail in later lectures. For now, just important to know that the bootstrap current exists and it is basically a self-generated current by the plasma. And the bootstrap current is proportional to the square root of the inverse aspect ratio over the poloidal magnetic field, and then the radial plasma pressure gradient. So the larger it is, the larger is the bootstrap current. Okay, now what can happen here? So if we have, due to a tearing mode appearing, a local change in the plasma pressure gradient, then this will result, due to the resulting change in the bootstrap current, in a perturbation of the plasma current. A perturbation in the plasma current, as you might remember from the chapter, from the video where we talked about islands, leads to the formation of islands. Now, islands, as I just explained on the previous slide, leads to local change in the plasma pressure gradient, and so on and so on. So basically what we have here is something like a self-amplifying system. So this is a self-amplifying system and can thus be dangerous. Now, this kind of mechanism is called a neoclassical tearing mode. So this, what I've just illustrated here, what I've just drawn here, this is called a neoclassical tearing mode, or short NTM. And it is called, or the expression neoclassical just refers to the bootstrap current being involved. We will talk about other neoclassical effects later on. Neoclassical just means basically that we have a toroidal magnetic field. And I should probably add that this is not in all cases self-amplifying, but it is self-amplifying if the seed magnetic island with which it started is large enough. So if we have just some small islands, these will not all lead necessarily to NTMs. Now let's have a look at an example from an experiment, something we already talked about. So here you can see an island structure with a threefold symmetry. So here 1, 2, 3 islands on one flux surface. You can see the resulting electron temperature profile on the right hand side. First of all, the unperturbed profile, and then the perturbed profile with the open circles, where you here have the cut across the O point of the island. You see the overall decrease of the electron temperature, and due to the self-amplifying mechanism, the potentially self-amplifying mechanism of the magnetic islands, of the NTMs, NTMs can finally lead to disruptions, and this is why they are so dangerous. So NTM, the neoclassical tearing mode, can lead to disruptions. Disruptions were discussed in towards the very end of the last video, and from that you should remember that a disruption is something we want to avoid at a large scale experiment. They do not necessarily lead to disruption. They could also saturate at some large size, which is, however, also problematic, because this means the overall plasma pressure is reduced, and not only is the plasma pressure reduced, but because the plasma pressure is reduced, it also means the plasma beta is reduced. Therefore, you have a less efficient experiment. Basically, it's the confinement is worse. There exist, however, techniques to handle these MTMs. And one example is, for example, well said, is to trying to replace the current which is missing. Remember when I said that a local change in the plasma pressure leads to perturbation in the current, to a reduction in the current. Now, if we would be able to locally replace the current by, for example, adding the missing current in this position here, or in this position, or in this position, then we could restore the original profile. And this is actually precisely what is done, and this is done by local microwave heating. So microwaves can locally deposit the energy and then drive a current, very localized, trying to restore the original profile and thus getting rid of the NTMs. This is something which has been successfully demonstrated in ASDEX Upgrade and in the D3D tokamak, and it is something which such a system will also be installed in ITER exactly for this purpose, to handle the NTMs. Okay, that's it for this video, where we talked about the internal kink instability. You learned about the sawtooth instability, about tearing modes, and we talked in detail, about the neoclassical tearing mode, an important instability, which can, however, be controlled or be mitigated by localized current drive by microwaves, for example. That's it. Hope to see you in the next video.